Hi everyone, it's Becky here. So today I'm out about again to do an outdoor sketch. So I'm walking in my neighborhood and all of a sudden I found the last bits of red trees around the cul-de-sac. They look just so brilliant under the evening sunshine. So I'm walking closer and trying to find a spot to sit down and sketch this street view. Okay, so now I'm sitting on the right shoulder of the street and I have this view in front of me. As you can see, there's perspective here. I think this is the basic one-point perspective. Okay, and now I will show you my process sketching it. First with pen and then watercolors. Okay, so before I start showing you my real-time process, I'm gonna do a quick thumbnail sketch. This is done after I finish the sketch back home. So this is the horizon line, and the direction of the street is kind of like this. These two lines are going towards a vanishing point somewhere there. And this line coming down is kind of like a guideline for where the top of the trees are. Same at the other side. Okay, so now I'm going to do a really quick sketch to show you the main things in my sketch. So this is the house at the end of the cul-de-sac. One car and another car on the side of the street. And this is the main tree on the left hand side and the main tree on the right hand side. So we don't have to stick really stiffly to the guidelines of perspective. There are actually a lot of smaller trees around, growing very loosely. Okay, so now I'm drawing a square frame to easily fit everything inside and writing down the day and the date. It was in late November, November the 23rd. So because I don't use a pencil to start sketching rough outlines, I'm using hand gestures and my eyes to visualize the size and placement of the perspective and all of those major objects in this landscape. So now I am drawing this important line. This is the sidewalk line, and this is the other sidewalk line, all pointing to the one point, vanishing point, around the horizon. And now I am drawing this car in the far distance. It's very tiny because it's far away. And then seeing another car slightly bigger on my side of the street. So I see front views and back views of cars as pretty simple, almost square shapes. They don't have that much three dimensions showing. And some other urban stuff like poles, light poles. There was a garbage can there too. And there's a little tree here beside the light pole. So it's all about finding small distances and relationships between each single object. And then another smaller tree. According to perspective, this tree looks a little bit higher because it's closer to the viewer. And there's a garbage bin here. It was garbage collection day. Okay, so this part is a little bit tricky because this light pole is being covered by this large tree, one of the main trees in this landscape. So after drawing the upper part of the light pole, I'm starting to connect the outline of this large red tree from its right side. mind adding some inner details like branches and twigs after finishing the outline. And underneath this big tree, there are other stuff like bushes trimmed in like snowman shapes. And then adding further little details and leaf details for the tree using very simple squiggly lines. Again, we don't have to draw every single detail that's on a tree, it's too much. So just do a few to suggest the tree form and that's good enough. Or I found some sketchers, they don't add these inner details at all. They just paint the colors on. So after drawing the details for this large tree, I see a lot of abstract details behind its negative spaces, like the gaps in between and behind and around. So just adding those shapes and dark areas that I see, I don't have to know what's really there. Just follow the abstract lines and form that I see and fill it in. And I see there's another tall tree behind. The leaves are hanging loose. So I just drew like the main tree trunk in the very middle and just add those loose leaves on both sides. And getting lower around. And this part I see house and a car. It's like a driveway there. All right. So these details are pretty clear. Two cars parked on a driveway and there's a form of a house. Another house and car form there. And another tree with bare branches here around the end of the street. And on the very end of the street is this house. So I'm starting to draw the rooftop and the body part divided into sections with windows. Here's one window, another window here. I really love drawing windows because those are like eyes for the houses. Another tiny car there parked on the driveway. Another window up there. Finishing this bare branch tree here. It's another cone-shaped tree behind. A lot of details to see. Adding some accentuation for the house. And I think there's a square bush here. And now I am turning back to normal real-time speed to show you how I draw a tree. So I just started with the middle part, which is the trunk. And then with smaller branches and twigs emerging from the middle part. These are like the fingers of the tree. And paying attention to the length of each branch too. And just try to add as many twigs as you can because there are too many twigs. And then finding the bottom of the trunk. And just adding this super short tree in front of this large tree. Very thin tree trunk. It's almost overlapping with a large tree. Then adding some final branches and twigs for this large tree. And now I'm starting to add the foliage of the tree. So again, focusing on the outline first before adding the inner details. And the middle to the bottom part of this tree has sections of loose leaves in smaller chunks. So I'm seeing that and drawing those loose shapes with a lot of broken lines. When drawing trees like this, I like to use very loose and broken lines in a relaxing way. And again, try your best. You don't have to be exactly the same as the tree in real life. We're just trying to capture the essence very quickly with these lines, and it doesn't have to look exactly the same. So don't stress out on the details. Focus more on the broader outlines and proportions and the stuff. So this house is a central focus point of this sketch. So I'm coloring the rooftops black just to make it stronger. And also adding some thicker lines for this tree too to make it stand out even better. Adding more evergreen trees in the distance. And these are pretty much square cubed shaped bushes in front of those houses. And just adding a bit of detail for the bottoms. And okay, now I am gonna draw these horizontal lines. It's quite important to give more sense of depth. So these are lawns and the walkway division lines. And here's another little tiny little bush over here. And just darken this line here just to give more dimension for the lawn. It pops up a bit from the flat surface. And adding a few fallen leaves here for the lawn. Pretty simple little shapes. A bit of leaves here too, underneath this tree. Okay, so here I am moving to the very last part of my drawing process, just adding these final little details here and there and to add some more accentuations to make some forms pop up even more. So as you can see, I'm just adding, darken that roof over there and add some more loose fallen leaves on the ground. More textures for these square bushes and for these trees in the distance. And that's it for the drawing part. So now it's time to paint with watercolors. So as you can see, I'm wetting the sky area first with clear water. This is the first layer. And now wet on wet, I'm putting on some medium yellow mixed with orange to have this golden color in thin streaks. Just keep it quite watery right now. And putting on cerulean blue for the top part of the sky. Again, pretty watery because the sky should be translucent compared to the other solid things. Okay, just let the blending go by itself without overstirring. And wet on wet, some red-orange color. So I mix this color with magenta and orange. While waiting for the sky to dry a bit, now I'm adding the first watery layer for the street. Everything looks golden right now because the sunshine is very strong. And by doing an underpainting this way, it really gives a strong sense of atmosphere. Okay, now I'm putting on some stronger tones with less water and more paint pigment of yellow-orange for the trees here and there. As you can see, I'm just starting to paint these light colors instead of adding greens and blues and other colors right now. Just stick to yellow and orange right now. So now I'm adding a pretty solid layer of orange for the main trees on the left-hand side and on the right-hand side. And now I'm starting to add some light green by mixing in radiant green with yellow here and there as I observe. So this light green is very common when sunshine is pretty strong shining on them. Okay, and now I am mixing some shade color for the clouds. I mix ultramarine blue with purple to have this color. The sky dried up a bit, but it's not completely dried. As you can see, there's a little bit bleeding going on. And I want this effect. The paper, the wetness was perfect. It was not too wet and it's not totally dried up yet. It's great. It's a great timing to do this wet on wet technique to add a shade color for these clouds. Okay, so I think the sky is done. I'm not gonna overpaint on it because the more we stir on the painting surface, the more muddy it could get. I wanna preserve the golden clouds without adding way too much shade color. Okay, the second layer. So now I am putting on a lot of magenta for the second layer of the tree here. These trees have a vibrant red color. And same for this one here. So I mix less water into the magenta, so it looks pretty strong and solid compared to the sky. Just using a lot of small, choppy brush strokes to paint these loose leaves. So I also mix in a little bit green into the magenta to have a kind of a dark red brown color. And now I'm mixing in a shade color of green by mixing in radiant green with burnt sienna to paint the bottom parts of some trees as I observe. Okay, just keep adding some more yellow greens and reds here and there as I missed before. And painting brown for these tree trunks. Keep adding more dark shades of green around the bottom parts of the trees. And then adding some quick colors, shade colors for these houses because they're not completely white. They have a bit of shade. And same of these driveways and walkways. Just a tiny bit of retouch here for the sky and clouds. And again, mixing radiant green with burnt sienna for the shade color for the trees and bushes. The color is not very dense and preserving the light yellow green from the first layer because I want to save the sunshine green color. And painting the lawns. It's very thin green, mixed in with a little bit leftover yellow. Could be medium yellow or lemon yellow. And just painting a shade color for the street using leftover colors such as greens, ultramarine blue, and keep it quite transparent because I really want to keep the street bright with the reflected color from the sky, nice and bright. And keep adding some more red orange color for the trees, for the fallen leaves, here and there, very small bits. And painting these fallen leaves are pretty important because these ones on the ground are forming a unity with the trees above. So it's good to accentuate them, make them a little bit stronger, let them pop up. And lastly, I want to add a shade color or more intense color for these red trees. So the complementary color of red is green. So I mix the leftover green into magenta orange to get this shade color. Or we can also use purple. So I think there are no super strict rules about the use of colors and how to mix them. There are many ways. Okay, and just use small loose brush strokes to add the form of leaves. And some last bits of green, just to add another layer of depth for the trees. So while I was sketching this picture, the neighbors came back and their cat came out to observe me. She's really cute. Maybe a bit shy, she's hiding around. And then she walked away. So as I was painting, a lot of people came back from work and their trucks and cars were covering my view. So I had to use my memory to paint the scenery. So thank you so much for watching my video. If you like my video, please click like and leave me a comment below. Subscribe to my channel for weekly updates. And I will see you again very soon. Have a great day.